won't be like London out here, children. The air raids don't come out this far.
Oh, Uncle Diggory. I just wish Mother and Father could be safe with us here.
Remember that Father said not to worry about them, and that the war would be over soon.
That's right, Peter. Don't worry, Susan.
Isn't this the most super house you've ever been in? The gardens, the statues, and that magnificent spire.
The history is all in the book.
What book?
Noted Manors and Castles of Great Britain. Page 313.
Let's see. 311, 312, 313. Here it is, Susan.
Marbleton Manor. Marbleton Manor, that grand mausoleum, holds more bric-a-brac than the British Museum. Its rooms and its galleries ramble for miles. A hodgepodge of odd architectural styles.
The cellars and dungeons are ancient and striking, most probably Celtic or possibly Viking. The mansion is Gothic in much of its feeling, though late Anglo-Norman in parts of the ceiling. The splendid old tower is High Roman-esque, combined with a variant version of Persian grotesque.
But the windows and doors are the soul of the place, as they light shifting patterns of shadow and space, creating a strange, unforgettable aura of grimness and grace.
I don't care about doors and windows. I want to go home to London.
You don't care about doors and windows. Why, when I was your age, I got half my education from opening windows and doors.
Doors and windows, they open and close. They hide or expose all the world to your view. The gates and shutters, they lock and unlock. They beckon or block wonders waiting for you. Now doors will never yield to doubters who go around moping. But if you're full of hope, you're holding the key that will open each door and window, window and door.
Children, I'm not talking about architecture, but the architecture of possibilities. Do you see?
I think I do. Doors and windows, bolt and unbolt, and only an adult wouldn't want to go through. And you will find your doors wherever your destiny plops you.
No more.
They'll swing themselves wide for you.
Stand right aside for you.
Pliantly slide for you. Surely provide for you.
Wonderful worlds to explore.
I want to go home. I don't like museums.
He doesn't like it because we all said we did.
Boys, just to be contrary.
He's always worse when Mother's away.
I am not, brat. How dare you?
Children, children, children. I am going to take your bags to your room, and when I return, I shall bring tea and biscuits. And if you're lucky, some chocolates.
I prefer Turkish delight.
What a beautiful old mansion.
I think it's boring.
Oh, Edmund.
Come on, Ed. It'll be a fun place to explore.
I'm sad we had to leave Mother and Father, but at least we get to spend some time in the country. I'm going to love staying here with the old professor. Isn't he a dear?
Yes, but I'm not sure I like his housekeeper. Please remember to always stay out of my way. Come on, Ned. Let's go to the room with all the swords and suits of armor.
You go ahead, Peter. I think I'll go down to the library and look through some books. What about you, Lucy?
This room over here seems very interesting.
There's nothing in it but a big old clock and a big old wardrobe.
But it's the largest wardrobe I've ever seen. I want to take a closer look at it.
Come on, Ned.
I'd rather go explore outside.
But it's raining. Let's go to the sword room.
All right, but only until we can go outside.
Oh, don't get lost. It's almost time for dinner.
Oh, Susan, stop talking like Mother.
Well, someone has to be in charge since Mother and Father aren't here. Lucy, come down to the library with me. It'll be much more exciting than an old room with nothing but a wardrobe. Lucy? I thought she went in there. Well, I guess she changed her mind. I think our stay here is going to be quite an adventure. Quite an adventure indeed.
What's so good about it?
And what are you doing out so early?
I was trying to catch the white stag, but I missed him again.
Well, don't give up, dearie. The white stag will give you good fortune, if you can catch him.
I know.
It'll take more than good fortune to help any of us.
Poor dearie. He's in a bad mood. His dam broke last night.
Oh, it's more than that. It's this blasted cold weather. I'll never get used to it.
But it's always cold weather in Narnia, Mr. Beaver.
Yeah.
There's nothing to be done about that.
Oh, well, maybe there's something to be done about it.
And what's that, Miss Centaur?
We can hope and pray that our king will soon return.
We keep hoping and praying, but he has not been seen for years.
That's true.
Not in my time, or even my father's time.
Not her father's time.
Then we must all have more faith.
I think Miss Centaur is right.
I think so, too.
I think we should break this meeting up in a hurry.
Why is that, Mr.
Beaver? Oh, shh. Listen. Come on, you!
It sounds like... Oh,
not that scoundrel.
I'm terribly sorry, sir.
And Tumnus the Fawn!
Poor Tumnus! How did he ever get himself mixed up in that bad business?
Whatever the reason, he's in a mess. And we will be too if we're seen by that rascal Fenris Ulf.
Mr. Beaver is right. Goodbye, everybody.
Goodbye. Don't forget to pray diligently for the return of our king.
Yes, yes, indeed. Let's go. Ooh.
Who was that? What was that flurry of activity?
Probably just the blizzard, sir.
Probably the enemy. But they scatter swiftly upon the arrival of Fenris Ulf, captain of Narnia's secret police. Now, why were you late coming to your post this morning?
I really don't think I'm needed here, sir. A son of Adam or Eve has never been here before.
But one will come someday, and it'll be your job to catch them. In fact, one may come along this very day. There's a smell of a human in the air. And do you know what the queen will do to you if you don't catch them?
To turn me into a stone statue?
At the very least. I must go and check on the other sentinels. Mind your post, knave!
Yes, sir. Whatever you say, sir. Oh, how did I get myself mixed up in this? My father would be so disappointed in me. Oh, well. Hopefully, a child of Adam or Eve will never come this way. But if one does, I can take it to the queen, and she will reward me. But that would be wrong, I think. Oh, I'm perplexed, as usual. I don't know what to do. Except what I always do when I'm perplexed. Play my pipe. Goodness gracious me!
Oh, I'm terribly sorry.
Who are you?
My name's Lucy.
Lucy? Are you a daughter of Eve?
A what?
A daughter of Eve. A human.
Well, of course I'm a human.
Good. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Tumnus. I'm a faun.
I'm very pleased to meet you, Mr. Tumnus. It's just a hand. You shake it.
May I ask, oh Lucy, daughter of Eve, how have you come into Narnia?
Narnia? Oh, what's that?
It's this. All the land that lies between this lamppost and the great castle of Caer Paravel on the eastern sea is Narnia. How did you get here?
I don't know. You see, I was exploring with my sister and two brothers.
Oh, there are four of you. Would they be coming as well?
I'm not sure. We were visiting this house in the country, and all of a sudden I stepped into this large wardrobe in a spare room.
Wardrobe? Spare room?
Spare room, yes. But then there was no back to the wardrobe, and I ended up here in...
Narnia. Oh, you'll be so glad you came. And I hope the others will find their way here as well. That way I can show all of you our beautiful country and introduce you to our lovely queen.
Everything seems so magical here.
It's always winter here, now. I remember summer, though. Fireflies and mushrooms and berries as big as your nose. Come and have tea with me and tell me of summer in the land of wardrobe. Is there war in the land of wardrobe?
Oh, yes, a horrible war. But I don't have time to stay and talk about it now. You see, my Uncle Diggory is making his tea, and I'm late now, and
well,
I'm freezing.
I live just around the bend. There's a warm fire, and tea, and cakes.
Cakes? Well, maybe I have time for some tea and a cake, but then I must...
Oh, thank you. Thank you, daughter of Eve.
It's Lucy.
Lucy.
Did you say before that it's always winter here?
Always winter. And never Christmas. And never spring either.
Well, hasn't it ever been spring here?
Yes. A long time ago. I remember when these woods were warm and green. And the white stag roamed, and if you caught him, you'd be granted three wishes. A time in Narnia when all the creatures danced gaily beneath the golden sun.
How beautiful you make it sound.
You can't imagine how beautiful it was. You had to be there to know how beautiful it was. Just think of springtime becoming summer. That's how it always was in Narnia. If I could show you the mornings we had then, when every dewdrop was like a diamond in the sun. You can't imagine that magical glow. You had to be there in Narnia to know.
back when Bacchus would provide the wine in drinking horns to cool us on the August afternoons, while nymphs and satyrs frolicked with the unicorns to Pan's enchanting tunes. You can't imagine how wonderful it was. You can't imagine how happy we were then, before the wind came and brought the snow. Yes, things were lovely so long ago. You had to be there in Narnia to know. You can't imagine how happy we were then, before the snow came, the endless snow. Yes, things were lovely so long ago. Our hearts were free there. You had to be there in Narnia. No.
What? What is it?
I'm not a nice fawn. In fact, I'm a very bad fawn.
No, you're the nicest fawn I've ever met.
How could I be when I work for her?
Her? Who's her?
The White Witch, that's who. Oh, she calls herself a queen, but she's the evil ruler of Narnia. She's the one who makes it always winter here. Always winter and never Christmas.
Well, what kind of work do you do for the witch?
I'm a kidnapper. I'm supposed to kidnap innocent children and bring them to her.
Oh, well, you wouldn't do anything of the sort.
But I am doing it. At this very moment.
What do you mean?
I'm supposed to take you to the witch.
But you wouldn't, would you, Mr. Tumnus?
If I don't turn you over to the witch, she'll cut off my tail, saw off my horns, or worse. She'll turn me into a stone statue with her magic wand.
Well, maybe she won't know I was here. Will you please just let me go home?
Of course I will. I didn't know what a human was like before I met you. But now that I know you, I can't turn you over to the witch. I'll take you back to the lamppost. From there you can find your way back to the wardrobe in the land of Sparrowhelm.
Thank you, Mr. Tumnus.
We must go as quietly as we can. The woods are full of her spies. Can you ever forgive me for what I meant to do?
Oh, certainly. And I hope you don't get into dreadful trouble on my account.
Farewell, daughter of Eve. I hope none of her spies saw me. I feel ever so much better now. Sorry, now I'm going to turn over a new leaf. I'm going to be a much better...
Aha! Tumnus, your treachery has been discovered.
No. No.
You had a human in your very grasp and you let her go.
No.
The queen will deal with you, Tumnus the traitor. I ordered this house destroyed. You won't be needing it anymore, betrayer of the queen. This document will serve notice to any who may have had the same notion as you. Come, Tumnus. Soon your name will be written in stone. Your very own!
Lucy, you're crazy. This is just another big old wardrobe like any other big old wardrobe. With lots of coats inside. It's dark. And stuffy and cold. Cold? It was warm in the wardrobe.
But now we're in Narnia.
Narnia?
You didn't believe me. I wanted to tell Peter and Susan, but you were the first one that I found. And I wanted to get back here as soon as possible.
I thought you were teasing, but I guess you were right after all.
Now the first thing we must do is see if Mr. Tumnus, the fawn, is safe. Oh, I hope the White Witch didn't get him.
Witch? There's a witch here in Narnia?
Yes, an evil witch that makes it always winter and never Christmas. Now, where in the world, in Narnia, is Mr. Tumnus's home? I could have sworn it was right over here. You have to help me look for him. Come, Edmund.
I have no desire to go traipsing off after some silly fawn. I'll be here at the lamppost if I stay. I'm not sure I like it here.
Well, don't leave without me. I'll be right back after I make sure Mr. Tumnus is okay.
Narnia, eh? I didn't believe Lucy.
Hold there! Tie the reindeer to that tree, dwarf!
Yes, Majesty. Dinner is done.
Now, let us follow the smell of the intruder.
Me?
Yes, you. Kneel in the presence of the mighty ruler of Narnia.
But I am kneeling.
Lower! There. That's more like it.
What, pray, are you?
I'm Edmund.
Is that any way to address a queen?
I'm sorry. I didn't know, Your Majesty. I thought you were a witch.
A witch?
I am a queen. The Queen of Narnia. Now, I repeat, what are you?
I'm a boy, Your Highness.
A boy? Did you hear that, dwarf? A boy.
Must be a son of Adam!
He looks more like an idiot to me. Tell me, boy, how did you enter my dominion?
I don't know. I was walking through the wardrobe. And then, in an instant, I was here.
A wardrobe? A passageway from the other world? The world of men? Oh, this could ruin everything. It could even be the beginning of the dreaded prophecy. Unless... My poor child, how cold you look.
If you'll excuse me, I must go find my sister, Lucy.
Lucy?
Yes, my little sister.
Oh, a daughter of Eve? And where is she? Where?
I don't know. She went traipsing off after some silly fawn. I also have an older brother and an older sister.
Why, that makes me...
Four of you? Four? My poor lost little lamb. Are you cold? Do I detect a shiver? Do I perceive a shake? Of course you must be freezing there without a comfy coat to wear. It's almost more than I can bear. It makes my poor heart break. My precious son of Adam, how miserable you look. Come sit by me and I'll contrive a rosy, warm, and cozy little nook. There, isn't that better?
Yes, Your Highness.
And would you like a warming drink?
Oh, yes, Your Highness.
Hot nectar of ambrosia. Better
than anything I've ever tasted.
Oh, you think that's good? I'll give you something really enchanting. There's a tantalizing candy no one can resist. All it takes is just a single bite. When you try this choice confection, suddenly your tongue will do a genuflection. Turkish, Turkish delight.
Caviar is simply fish, shake, champagne's only fish. Truffles merely dull the appetite. They don't give you half the thrill of what no human being never gets his fill of Turkish,
Turkish,
Turkish, Turkish delight.
Turkish delight,
Turkish delight. It's like a wild fever you caught. Turkish delight, Turkish delight. It's like a flame that can't be put.
It's right, your mother, for these
gleaming cubes of lime and lemon quince and kumquat juice, sugared with the dust of snowy white. They all share that special savor. Taste forbidden fruit, I think you'll like the flavor. Turkish,
Turkish,
Turkish delight. Desire it, empower it, receive it, devour it. Go ahead, take a bite.
Sweeter than the sweetest honey, creamier than cream. Takes my senses to a dizzy height.
Mortals always lose control for morsels of a goodie. They can sell their soul for Turkish,
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 Turkish, Turkish, Turkish delight.
The best Turkish delight I've ever had. May I have some more?
Of course. Back in my castle, I have rooms filled with Turkish delight.
Then let's go there right now.
First, you must fetch the others.
They can come another time.
Now! Bring them to my castle. It lies between those two hills over there. You can smell the Turkish delight all the way. Come, dwarf. We must prepare for our esteemed guests. Oh, Edmund. One more thing. Don't tell your brothers and sisters about me just yet. I want them to be surprised when they see me. Let's keep this visit our little secret.
Me, a prince. My every wish a command. I'm glad she told me she was a queen, or else I might have mistaken her for a witch.
Edmund, this is horrible. I can't find Mr. Tumnus anywhere.
Maybe we should go grab Susan and Peter.
You really want to? I didn't think you liked it here.
Well, maybe this place does deserve a second look.
Good. Well, let's go get Susan and Peter.
And this time we'll bring some coats from the wardrobe. It's cold here.
As I told you, it's all the witch's fault.
Oh, go on, Lucy. There's no such thing as a witch.
And we'll just have to wait.
Yes, this other business is much more important. Look, there's Miss Unicorn. We'll tell her.
Miss Unicorn, over here, you will. Humans have been here. Remember the prophecy.
The prophecy.
Listen, I heard the most wonderful news. They say he has arrived.
Excellent. Our king? How excellent. Wonderful! Yeah. We must keep the humans hidden from the witch.
Yes,
exactly.
Mr. and Mrs. Beaver, you must help them.
Okay, yes.
But...
I think I see it.
It's
close.
Come on.
Oh, dear.
But...
Come on, follow me. It's just a little bit closer. Let's go, I see it.
Are you sure it's this way?
Yes, come on.
But what if the children are afraid of me? Or don't trust me? I better hide until I get my wits together.
Come on, just a little bit further. Follow me. Now are you convinced, Peter?
Yes. I apologize, Lou, for not believing you.
It's so different. It's also very cold.
Well, that's why we grabbed these coats from the wardrobe, Susan.
Well, what do we do first?
Explore, of course. I say we go in that direction.
Well, don't forget where the lamppost is. That's our landmark. We need to find it when we wish to return home.
I say we go home now. It's scary here.
Don't be such a goose, Susan. Where's your sense of adventure?
Well, whether we stay here or not, we must at least find poor Mr. Tumnus.
But you tried already. You couldn't even find his house.
I could have sworn it was right over here.
Look, what's that?
A message of some kind. The former occupant of these premises, Fawn Tumnus, is under arrest and awaiting trial on a charge of high treason against Her Imperial Majesty Jadis, Queen of Narnia.
Signed, Fenris Ulf, Captain of the Secret Police. Long live the Queen.
Oh, no.
Who is this Queen, Lou?
She's not a real queen at all. She's a horrible witch that makes it always winter and never Christmas in Narnia.
It doesn't seem safe here. What about just going home?
But we must at least try to rescue Mr. Tumnus. It's my fault he's in trouble.
I suppose Lou is right.
Very well, but this place worries me.
Where do we look first?
I say we look for something to eat.
Oh, you're always thinking about your stomach.
You're always thinking about your hair and your clothes and how you look.
Please.
Well, if I look like you.
You too. Stop acting like brothers.
I just wish I knew where Mr. Tumnus was imprisoned.
Well, why don't we check at that castle between those two hills?
Very well.
Perhaps it will be warmer there.
What was that?
Nothing, scaredy cat. Let's go.
Who's there?
Come out of there. Yes, you. Come over here. Are you with the Wicked One, or are you not?
Who are you?
Don't you be asking us questions, lad. What just scavengers want here?
And where's Tumnus? Who busted up his cave?
Not us. You see, I'm a friend of Mr. Tumnus.
How do we know you're not something the witch brood?
The witch? There's really a witch?
Oh, aye, lass.
What are you?
I'm a beaver, I am. And this here's me bickering wife.
Hey!
Well, what would you do that for?
I don't bicker.
You bicker all the
if
time.
If anybody bickers,
you're always yelling.
Look, we came to find Mr. Tumnus, and we found this.
Oh, it's just what I feared. Please, tell us what's going on.
You're humans, ain't you?
Yes, we're humans.
Oh, hush, shh.
She means to say, humans ain't safe here. That's what this here note means.
Why must we be quiet? There's no one here but us.
There's the trees, ducky. Most of them are on our side, but some would tell her. The witch.
Tell her what?
Well, tell him.
Not here, not here. I thought I saw an elm tree just clench its branches. Oh. Further up and further in, children.
Come here, you children. Toodaloo, elm tree. May your mom come down with a blight. Let's...
Children, get comfortable. Take your coats off.
Oh, settle in, children.
Words about the kingdom that Aslan is back in Narnia.
Oh, at last, to finally see Aslan. I feel lovely music in my soul.
I feel brave and daring to the quick.
I feel like I feel when school's over for the term.
I think I'm feeling sick.
Who is Aslan?
Who's Aslan? You mean to say you don't know who Aslan is? Oh, why, he's the proper lord of the wood. And where it is, he's on the move and raising an army of us loyal ones to fight that tyrant, the White Witch.
Why, he's the very breath of life to us, the heart and soul of everything true and beautiful in Narnia.
He is the golden lion, fiercer than the sun. He is the waiting seed that sleeps beneath the snow. Son of the emperor who dwells beyond the seas. Aslan is all of these. He is the newborn lamb, the firstling of the flock. He is our bold and valiant captain in the war. He is the tender wind that whispers to the trees. Aslan is all of these and more. We've kept our faith in him, deep and strong, silently awaiting him. Upon the shore. He is a timeless will, abiding clear and pure. Firm as a mighty rock and gentle as a breeze. Aslan is all of these, oh, all of these and
Aslan, will he help us find Mr. Tumnus?
Oh, the poor bloke's probably turned to stone. A bloody statue in the witch's courtyard. Or in that bloody wanderer's.
Look, we're strangers here. We shouldn't be taking sides.
Well, we must do something. It's my fault he's in trouble.
Oh, you can't save him, dearie. You can't go on them grounds and come out alive.
I say we go home and let this lion and this witch settle their own dispute.
That's not such a bad idea.
Let's see what Aslan has to say first. You'll meet him tomorrow at the stone table. There's reasons you're here, believe you me.
What have we to do with anything in this icebox called Narnia?
When Adam's flesh and Adam's bone sits at Caer Paravel enthroned, the evil time will be over and finally done.
It's one of the oldest proverbs in Narnia.
Yes, but what does it mean?
You're Adam and Eve's flesh and bone, right?
And the witch is the one that brought this evil time here, eh?
And Caer Paravel is the castle of the rightful kings and queens of Narnia. So the witch will pull out her slimiest tricks to keep you humans from them thrones and keep her power.
But isn't the witch a human?
Ooh, in no way.
I don't understand. Thrones? Us? We're just four school children.
You can't be children forever, lad. But only Aslan will know if you four are the right four. I say... Where's the other bloke?
Edmund?
I can tell you. He's gone to the White Witch now. I thought he had a smell of a body, was with her, and ate her food.
Oh.
I'm sure of it.
Now I smell it?
Oh. I'll bet that little liar did go see the White Witch before we got here.
If he's gone to warn the witch about you and Aslan, we gotta fly from here, we do.
Ooh, they'll be after us. I have to make sure to get my sewing machine.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. We take nothing, missus. Who ever heard of desperate beings running for their lives with a sewing machine?
But you know them! They'll smash it! I'll come and get everything we own! I have to have the sewing machine!
Look,
I can't make anything!
We're going home.
You can't go anywhere, so catch you before you get back. Everybody move, I say.
Oh.
This way. Fast. Fast. Faster.
Oh, dear. My good china.
Thank you.
This must be it. The queen's courtyard. These statues are so lifelike. Amazing. I'll be your new king after I get even with my brother and sisters. But once I'm crowned, I'm gonna change the climate here.
Who are you? What do you want here?
I'm Edmund.
What's an Edmund?
I'm an old friend of Her Majesty, the Queen.
So am I. I love her. Love her for how she deals with her enemies.
She likes me. She wants to make me king here.
Really? First I've heard of it. And I'm Fenris Ulf, head of the Queen's secret police.
Well, nice to make your acquaintance, Mr. Ulf. But I really came to see the Queen.
She can't be bothered.
She'll be angry if she isn't told I'm here.
Why she isn't when she is told? Tell Her Majesty that there's a Edmund here to see her.
Your Majesty! Your Majesty! Your Majesty!
Woo! Is that any way to summon a queen? Ah, Edmund, how wonderful to see you.
I came back just like I said I would, Your Majesty.
Where are the others? Didn't I command you to bring the others? How dare you come alone?
I did bring them. I left them with the old beaver couple. But wait, there's more. The beavers mentioned some talk about, well, dissatisfaction with your rule here in Narnia.
What? Dissatisfaction? With my rule? Why, that's treason! I'll put a stop to that! I'll put a stop to them! I'll make beaver hash out of those rodents! I'll find out everybody they talk to! I'll kill them!
Your Highness, you know it's terrible for your health when you get all hot and bothered like this.
I'm not hot and bothered, but I'm not in a sweat. To be quite precise, I'm as cool as ice. I'm relaxed as I can get. I'm not in a dither, and I'm not all at sea. You might think that somebody blew their top, but I guarantee it wasn't me. I was young, I lacked perspective. I was terrorized by fantasies and fears. As I've matured, I've grown objective. And I haven't gone to pieces in 400 years. There's no trace of a fever. There's no knocking of the knees. 'Cause my Fahrenheit is exactly right at a perfect 32 degrees.
No thanks to you.
Your Majesty, I'm just repeating what was said.
These lurid rumors are very dire, like an infection that taints the blood, and they can flare up like wildfires. I won't have them, I detest them. Those who spread them, I arrest them for the safety of the realm demands. I'll nip them in the bud.
But I'm not hot and bothered, and I'm not in a stew. If there's anyone who should worry, son, it should probably be you.
But Your Majesty, I'm just repeating what I heard. Something of a revolution here in Narnia.
It can't be true, there's nothing to it. Just malicious and seditious Tommy Rot. Don't lie to me, I'll make you rue it. You hateful and ungrateful little snot! What else have you heard?
Well, they said that Aslan is back and on the move, and that he's raising up an army against you.
Don't ever speak that name in my presence again! What? Aslan? Back here? On the move? Against me? Impossible! Unbelievable! Absolutely inconceivable! Take the most brutal of wolves you command. Fly like
like the wind to the home of those beavers, that den full of traitors and Aslan believers. Spare only the lives of the three mortal children, bind them in chains, bring them to me, but as for the rest, do what you will. Burn and destroy, ravage and wreck, savage and smash, obliterate, annihilate, and kill!
You're hot and bothered is what you're not. Not even the teeniest tiny jot. Your heart ain't racing and your nerves ain't shot as far as we can see.
Go. Go get the reindeer, we must be off.
To where, Your Highness?
To the stone table. If Fenris doesn't chew up those beavers, they'll take the children there to meet Aslan!
And keep your things tranquilized, you're the best. A marvelous model for all the rest. Of how to stay perfectly self-possessed despite adversity.
But I'm not hot and bothered.
No, you're not hot and bothered.
Not me.
Not she.
Not me.
Not she.
No,
not she.
I'm not hot and bothered.
Not she. Not she.
We could have just gone home. How many hours have we been walking?
Enough so that we'd better rest.
I'm so cold that I'm disheartened.
We gotta keep going. Gotta get you to Aslan before she catches us.
And if she's got that Edmund in her clutches, that's one more problem.
That's true.
Bet your life she's going by sleigh, too. That white one. How's it you never bought me a sleigh? Walk, walk, walk everywhere we go. You never give me nothing.
I bought you a sewing machine. I did.
34 years ago when you proposed to me. So now that you've won me, the presents have stopped, have they?
Gripe, gripe, gripe. Nothing but gripe.
Just like your old mom. Oh, my old mom was at least.
Oh, your old mom was the worst.
Hey, I hear sleigh bells.
Listen, witch, everybody hide. I can't believe my eyes!
Father Christmas!
Blimey! After all this endless crazy time, we'd about counted you out, mate!
Though it may seem it's been winter forever, and you feel numb from the snow, even to dream seems a useless endeavor as hope burns low. Joy for joy! The
winter and never Christmas. How'd you get back into Narnia?
Aslan is on the move, that's how. The White Witch's magic is weaker now. I felt it when I got up this morning, and my whole body tingling with warmth, love, and a magnanimous feeling of good fellowship. Oh, you all know the unmistakable of Christmas morning, where you just want to hug everybody? No.
Christmas comes back to Narnia. Bit of a miracle it is.
Correct. Not much to do. Come, take your presents.
Presents? For us?
Mrs. Beaver, when you get home, you'll find a new sewing machine.
Oh, does it have a buttonhole maker?
Yes.
Ain't that the luck of the white stag? Much nicer than the one you ever bought me.
You are so mean. You're literally so mean.
Now, you two. Give her a kiss, mister. It's that she's after. That's why she's always kissing at you.
It is? I'll do anything I will to stop that.
Righto. Mm-hmm.
Good. And for you, Mr. Beaver, when you get home, you'll find a new sluicescape for your dam.
Thank you, Father Christmas. You saved me 3 months' work.
That is, if the witch hasn't gone and destroyed everything.
She has, all will be restored. Oh, okay. Peter, advance, son.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
War toys, Father Christmas?
These are not toys, Susan, but tools. These are for you.
Well, we'll always cherish these gifts as a token of your generosity, sir.
Good. It's a special bow, Susan. Doesn't easily miss its target. And if you use this ivory horn, I think help shall come to you. Lucy.
Oh my! A bottle cut from a diamond!
But its contents, my girl, are far more precious still. Fireflies from the mountains of the sun. A few drops to anyone who is hurt, and they will be brought back to perfect health.
Oh my! Thank you, kind father. I think I can be brave.
And when you see Edmund, you can give him this.
I can't stand the sight of him, Father Christmas.
Hardly a Christmas sentiment.
Well, he doesn't deserve it, but I'll take it for him anyway.
Good. Now enjoy yourselves. Merry Christmas.
Oh, I can't believe it's Christmas. And with a buttonhole maker in the bargain. Oh, dear.
Long live the True King Aslan. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas.
You stopped me because you are hungry?
Well, could I possibly have one little piece of Turkish delight?
Turkish delight? You will taste food again when I do.
How long will that be? I can go maybe another hour. Maybe.
Last time she ate was 23 years ago. It was a little porridge, but she couldn't keep it down.
23 years ago. But if you haven't eaten in 23 years, then you wouldn't be human. And if you're not human, then what are you?
That song! I can't stand it! What is this about?
It's her!
Speak to me! I grant permission for you to address me!
Good day.
Don't good day me! Tell me where you got those sweets and those vulgar decorations. Tell me, or I will send my dwarf for Fenris Ulf, who craves blood.
Father Christmas gave them to us.
What? He can't have been here.
He has been. He has. We've seen him. He's back. Oh, we're so glad he's back.
Stone! There's Stone! Oh, Your Majesty, you shouldn't have.
Do not lecture me. My will is law here. You are nothing, less than nothing. Remember that.
I'll never be a prince or a king or anything else, will I?
Oh, and you had such faith in me, too. Prince, king, you.
But you promised me. You gave me your word.
I am a witch, fool. A witch doesn't have to keep promises. She has to make them.
A witch?
We must be off. Move quickly.
Them beech trees are putting on leaves.
And deliver us. So's that old plot of elms. A little thaw can do it. Well, what are you looking at?
Well, this ain't no simple thaw. By heaven, it's spring. It's a spring, I tell you.
Oh, dear. Well, I'll be blessed. The last time he kissed me like that was 20 years ago. When I had the flu and he thought I was going to kick the bucket. It's amazing what a bit of spring can do. What a simple little thing like spring can do. When the snow begins to melt and a warming trend is felt, roots you thought were dead may start to sprout anew.
It's tremendous what a trace of green can bring. It can stimulate a tree to add a ring, and each limb can swell in size as the sap begins to rise, till it seems it's almost bound to burst into.
It's amazing what a bit of spring can do. It's amazing, it's amazing, it's amazing what a bit of spring can do. All of the sudden, the whole world is budding. It switched from December to May. We're in a much warmer season, which must be the reason.
Every female's having fits.
Every female knows that it's amazing what a blaze of bloom breaks through. Quite a dandy and delightful dream come true. It can add a special zing to an old familiar fling. It's amazing what a bit of spring can do. It's outrageous.
It's contagious.
It's amazing what a little bit of blooming spring can do.
Is gripped by the power. Every creature feels the surge.
Mother Nature's on the spurt.
It's magic.
It's a miracle.
It's fate. It's a wonder.
It's a mystery. It's great. And the tasty tang of spice makes the whole thing twice as nice.
Which is why this eager beaver's in a stew.
It's cheeky and it's brazen.
It's a blessing beyond praising. It's amazing.
It's amazing.
It's amazing.
It's amazing. It's amazing what a little bit of blooming. March and April, May and June linger long and come back soon.
Bit of spring can do. Now on to the stone table and Aslan. Children, we're here. The stone table's just up the path. These will be Aslan's followers now.
Yoo-hoo! This is them. Adam's flesh, Adam's bone. Right here.
Here they are.
These are the ones you told us so much about.
Yes.
We're trying to find our brother so we can go home. Can you help us?
This is the royalty? Why, they're pups. Could there be some mistake?
Is he the eldest?
Yes, his name's Peter.
Mary's going to change because of them. You'll have to prove it to me.
Aslan don't know what to do.
I thought according to the prophecy there were to be four.
Yes, well.
The other son of Adam's been snared by her, the White Witch. It's him!
Peter!
Aslan!
I'm scared! Hold on to me! He's supposed to be a good king, isn't he? I suppose. Peter, you must say something to him.
Me?
Mm-hmm. You're the eldest. He must tell you what we're to do.
We have come, Aslan.
Peter, son of Adam. Susan and Lucy, daughters of Eve. Welcome, please. Step closer to me, all of you.
Oh, so very pleased to meet you, great sir. I'm so much less disheartened now.
That is because you're meant to be here. Meant to rule Narnia from the castle that is the seat of the true kings and queens. Care Parabel, look, children. Four thrones awaiting for the promised king to come. Four thrones that might fold in a new. But if you prove worthy and true, sons of Adam, daughters of Eve, the throne shall be waiting for you. The ancient prophecy may soon have come to pass. This land may be as it used to be, a land that was proud.
Then we are the four, the Adam's flesh and bones, of the prophecy the beavers told us?
Yes, the four. But where is the other?
Ooh, must have tried to betray him. Somehow he got hooked up with the White Witch, Aslan.
Calls himself Edmund.
Edmund.
I'm sure you don't want to meet him, Great Lion. Oh, he's awful.
No. For one who is not truly wicked. Can follow wickedness to get whatever he wants.
With all due respect, sir, I'm not sure if this is the family to sit on thrones, especially if there are some here in Narnia who don't want us. So, if you could just use your powers to get that brat Edmund back, we'll be on our way home and you can find four others.
There are no others. For what happens from here now on will not be simple. Rest a moment. My friends here and I will help you fight Edmund. We must have him back!
It will be done, Aslan.
He seemed to like us.
You're human. That gives you extra points.
But you haven't proven to me that they deserve to sit on thrones.
Nor me.
Give him a chance! Give him a flippin' chance! We don't know about humans, Ease.
It's the children that we want! Get away from us. We have no quarrel with you.
Hit him. Kill him.
Peter!
Kill him.
Kill him!
Peter.
But he could have gotten killed.
The prophecies are always right. Three cheers for Peter.
Peter.
Attaboy, Pete.
I killed a wolf, Susan.
It's horrible.
My son, you have been tested and passed. Eve.
What?
Eve, Peter, son of Adam.
Oh my, he's knighting him. My own brother.
I don't understand. I haven't even graduated school yet.
Nevertheless, when you rise from the earth of Narnia, you shall be Sir Peter the Defender. Now rise. Long live Sir Peter!
Long live Sir Peter!
And now, dear friends, we will find this witch and rescue Edmund. Let the prophecy be fulfilled!
The prophecy!
very well, my old adversary. Aslan. Aslan, yes! I can speak the name, for he shall soon be mine. The deep magic is on my side. Perhaps he has forgotten the deep magic, but I shall remind him. Dwarf, we must summon our allies to meet with us as soon as possible. Call the ghouls, the boggles, the ogres, the specters, the hags. This is war, and we shall fight with one aim in mind, to end forever the name of Aslan!
Your Highness, very fragile, these humans.
And very strong. Humans are nothing but contradictions. That is what I hate about them.
My little sister would say you were disheartened.
What is it? Trouble? Have the children met up with him?
Yes, the other son of Adam. He killed Rywife.
But Peter couldn't kill anything.
Then we must kill this human creature now.
What? Kill me.
It should be done on the stone table. That is the proper place. But in this emergency, we'll do it here, now, and quickly.
No, you can't. You wouldn't.
Oh, yes, we would.
And as a matter of fact, we often do.
We do maimings on Mondays to kick off the week. Whichever perfect hands with both style and technique.
Our boilings and oil are never humdrum.
They're on Wednesdays at 6. Say you'll come. There's rackings on Fridays for hours at a stretch.
Oh, what fun as we rend and distend some poor wretch.
But all such amusements are mere child's play. This is the good stuff, a murder today.
Call my loyal subjects to me. They must share this special moment.
Phantoms and furies, ogres and ghouls, zombies and specters and boggles and ghouls, children of darkness, attend what I say. A murder today, a murder today.
Vampires and demons, banshees and sprites, gorgons, hellions, and fetches and brights. Servants of terror, oh, hear and obey. Your queen bids you witness this murder today.
Thus shall all usurpers perish. All who challenge my command, quickly shall they know the bitter justice of my hand.
Mother of coldness,
of wormwood and gall. We hear your summons and answer the call. Where is our victim? Show us our prey.
Behold you, a human! A human to slay!
Murder today, murder today, murder today, murder today, murder today, murder today, murder today. Your Highness, come with you to the woods. Look!
Aslan's followers! Quickly, Your Highness, before the blood we smell is our own!
Set up guards around the perimeter!
Is he?
We got here just in time. He's only fainted.
Come on, son of Adam.
No! You can't! I say you can't! The knife!
Edmund, it's us!
She's going to kill me!
She's gone. It's all right.
Susan? Lucy? Peter? Oh, thank heavens.
Who are all? It's all right, Edmund. These are Aslan's followers.
You little rat. How could you betray us like that? Why,
Leave him alone. I don't care what he's done. We're all together again. Let's find the lamppost and go home. We have Edmund now. It's over for us.
It's not over, girl. It's only just begun.
Have you forgotten of the prophecy and the war?
I don't care about the prophecy, and I hate the war. I want to go home.
Oh, Edmund. No, you don't understand. What I was trying to do was, like...
Don't worry. This is the true king, Aslan.
Thank the great Aslan, Edmund.
Aslan's army is what saved you, lad.
Oh, thank you, Great Lion. They came just in time.
I'll say. Your throat was about to dribble down your bib, lad.
I wish to speak to this son of Adam alone.
To me?
You have betrayed your brother and your sisters. And when you have betrayed them, you have betrayed me. That pale butcher promised the whole kingdom, didn't she?
What would a little kid like me do with a whole big kingdom?
Look into my eyes, Edmund.
I can't. It's like trying to look into the sun.
Look into my eyes.
Myself.
It doesn't please you.
I see a liar, a traitor, and a coward. Is that me?
Yes. And do you wish to stay like that?
No, but it's the way I am. How can I be any different? About to swear? Some punishment to take?
Not by any oath, not by any vow, not by pain or penance, those can't help you now, not for birth or outward
grief. Then from where will come thing I need?
fruit or tree bear fruit
or flower grow.
So you must search within
and you must delve your deepest heart
so you can
plant new seeds
and grow plants heart.
Meal my soul, start to turn about, in my heart begin to heal from the inside out.
Oh, great lion, will you help me change?
You have taken the first step, but the road is long and hard, for we shall see. The business between me and Edmund is over. He's your brother again.
What'd he say?
Tell us what happened, Dad.
I just said, look, anybody can make a little mistake.
A little mistake? You call taking up with a witch a little mistake?
Take up? Like, I was just...
Move on back. Someone's coming.
Lackey, don't let him near me!
Calm down. He's under the flag of truce.
I have a message from the Queen of Narnia.
Well, what is it?
It's for him to hear.
What is your message, son of Earth?
Her Highness desires safe conduct. You'll be interested in what she has to say.
Tell the Queen of Ice I grant her safe conduct.
Back.
As the prophecy foretold.
Oh, yes. And you live by the law of every letter in prophecy, don't you?
You know I do.
You have to. Otherwise, all in Narnia will die by water and fire.
What is it that you want here?
I want the fulfillment of the law, down to the very last letter. I know what's due me, and I seek only justice. You can't refuse me what is mine without question. The law's perfect, and its claims are unchanging. Who could dare to defy the deep magic?
Under the deep magic of the Emperor.
I claim the boy is my legitimate victim. I have the right to take the blood of a traitor. And that this human is the vilest of traitors. Who could dare to deny the deep magic? Deep magic holds punishment for every crime. Take the blood of a traitor. Truly, vengeance is mine.
Can't you do something, Aslan?
She and I will speak further.
Speak further? The law is clear. All traitors are mine to kill, and I claim that one.
We shall speak further!
Aslan will do something. You'll see.
He usually does, but he can't go against the commandments of the Emperor, Sir Peter.
The law is clear.
He wouldn't turn me over to her, would he?
Aslan don't know what to do.
What even can he do? All traitors in Narnia are for her to kill.
Oh, would you stop talking about killing? You're scaring everyone.
I'm sorry, Susan, but I speak the truth.
The matter has been settled. The witch has renounced a claim on your brother's blood. Edmund is now free.
Dwarf, gather our forces. The time is at hand.
One last thing. How do I know your promise will be kept?
You know an Aslan makes a promise. It will be kept!
Aslan, what did she mean? What promise did you make to her?
Oh, Aslan, how'd you do it?
Tell us.
What magic did you work?
I must speak to the children. Please, leave us now.
What is it, Aslan?
Can't you tell us?
The witch has business in these parts. You must leave from here at once. Go to the fields of Bruna. You'll camp there tonight.
Won't you come with us?
I'll be needed here. Peter, she has business in these parts. And when she's done, you must be prepared for anything. Perhaps even a battle of life or death.
Won't you help us?
I can make no promise of that. Now please, go, all of you. Children, why did you not go with the others?
We're very worried, Aslan.
We're sure something dreadful's going to happen.
May we stay with you, Aslan,
please?
Yes, but only for a few moments. When I tell you to leave, you must.
Oh, we will.
Thank you.
Aslan, dear Aslan, what's wrong?
Are you ill, dear Aslan?
No. For I am sad, lonely. Place your hands upon my shoulder, that I may feel you close to me. The hour is now. If you wish to stay nearby, you may. But whatever you do, you must hide.
But, Aslan...
Under no circumstances can you let yourselves be seen. Farewell, my children. Now, please, hide.
Aslan!
Please, hide now!
All my life, I've waited to be a part of something this historic.
But I've never seen the like of Granville again, that's for certain.
The blood of this night will serve as a memory to thrill our hearts forever. We must tell Her Highness that all is in readiness.
Her territory. Oh my, we've come much too far.
Mother of darkness, now is the time. A king for a traitor pays for the crime.
Mother of darkness, now is the time. A king for a traitor pays for the crime. Mother of darkness, now is the time. A king for a traitor pays for the crime. Mother of darkness, now is the time. A king for a traitor pays for the crime.
The hour is now.
Who said it couldn't be done? The brightest gem in your crown of accomplishments. All hail the Queen of Narnia!
Hail the Queen of Narnia!
No need to be scared. The fool won't break his promise.
I am ready.
So, after all these years, bind him to the table. Well, move!
Mother of darkness, now is the time. A king for a traitor pays for the crime. Mother of darkness, now is the time. A king for a traitor pays for the crime. He looks different. He's just a big cat.
May we proceed? I've heard tale that the blood of kings is of a special scarlet hue and tastes of the finest of wines.
Your Majesty, are you sure he can't break these ropes?
Of course he can break these ropes and destroy the lot of you! But he promised his life to save Edmund, the son of Adam. He will do nothing. Has won. Fool! Did you think by all of this you would save the human traitor? When you are dead, what will prevent me from killing him as well and the rest of his kin? Remember that you have given me Narnia forever. You have not saved your own life, and you have not saved them. In that knowledge, despair and die! It is done!
Yeah.
The fool is dead! His power is dead! Yeah. Now to start the battle with the sons of Adam and the daughters of Eve!
He did this for Edmund.
The sun will
the sun never will rise again. What can we do? We can grieve for him and honor him and try to go on.
We must take him to the burial ground of ancient kings.
No! Not to a graveyard!
Lay him in a field of flowers, with sprays of lilac become his bed. Lay him in a field of flowers, with sprays of lilac beneath his head. The willow will weep, the swan.
The witch's army is coming. What do we do now? Who'll lead us?
Quick, all of you to your positions. Remember, we fight for Aslan and for Narnia! Sound retreat!
My plan has worked! They can retreat no further! They are trapped!
Ah!
So this is her plan. She has backed up right in her own courtyard.
Susan, you've been very brave. I know how hard this has been for you.
Well, there really isn't any choice when there's something lurking out there so evil, is there? I can see that now.
You should be proud, Sir Peter. You fought like a seasoned warrior.
What does it matter? She's got our army cut to pieces, and it's only a matter of when she wants to destroy us.
Not even the luck of the White Stag can get us out of this one.
Oh, my. Oh, my.
Don't be scared, Lou.
Look! It's Mr. Tumnus! But he's just a statue.
A lot of good he'll do you now unless you were to break him up and use him for your slingshot.
Oh, poor Mr. Tumnus. Even his tears are pebbles.
Oh, as ours soon will be. Oh, it feels like snow. Peter, what do we do?
Honestly, Susan, I don't know.
Peter, let me go to the witch.
No, Peter!
One of us dead, and the prophecy of the four thrones falls through.
How do you know she'd even let us go?
We have to risk it.
No, if anyone's going, it's going to be me. I'm leading this army.
It's all my fault. By everything right, it should be me.
Stop it, both of you! Whoever would I quarrel with? Make him shut up, Peter!
You can't stop me from going.
No, we're staying here and we're fighting to the end.
I can't believe this is happening. It's all a nightmare. All these swords and bows and arrows and battle plans all add up to nothing. Oh, but this stupid horn doesn't work either.
Aslan, but you were killed by the deep magic of the witch.
Yes, but there is a deeper magic the witch does not know of. For a magic that when someone innocent sacrifices himself for one who is guilty, the death moves in reverse and brings the innocent one back through the jaws of life.
You mean you're real? You're not a ghost?
Do I look like it? Dear ones, drop the mask of tragedy and disbelief, and this moment for joy.
This is a time for celebration, but we can't. The witch has got us backed up, and more than half our army is gone.
There's another army standing beside you, Sir Peter.
But they're statues.
My people have been locked in stone. It's time they were free. And feather. Can you see the witch's army?
She's upon us, man.
Kill them! Put an end to the prophecy and kill them!
Kill Give it back, Aslan. Give it.
Aslan! But I killed you myself under the deep magic!
There's a deeper magic at two north door. Prepare to die! White One is no more. Let the castle be her too.
Edmund!
Oh, dearie.
Oh, my.
He don't look too good.
Quick, Lou. The restorer from the gift Father Christmas gave you.
Oh, yes. Now, Edmund, don't you dare dishearten me anymore today. Open your eyes.
I'm hungry.
Oh, my God.
It's okay.
Seriously?
Edmund, you have proven yourself.
It's the least I could do after all the wrong I've done.
All have done wrong, Edmund, at some time or another. But to acknowledge error and to try harder is the best way to right that wrong. And that is what you have done.
What about the witch's army? Are we safe?
They'll still be around since the leader is dead, lurking in forbidden corners. But you must be always aware of them always.
Yes, Aslan.
And now, the only duty remaining is to crown the new kings and queens of Narnia! I wish to crown them on this very spot, but that will have to wait. To Caer Paravel, for that is where the four thrones are. To Caer Paravel!
Caer Paravel!
Edmund.
Queen Susan.
Long live Queen Susan.
Long live Queen Susan.
And Peter, the High King, first among equals.
Long live King Peter.
The High King should address his court.
Dear friends and subjects, ruling will not be easy for kings and queens who have yet to be princes and princesses. But with your help, we will do our best to... What exactly are we to do?
For use your time wisely. For Narnia, as the world you came from, there is never enough. Long live the true kings and queens of Narnia!
Woo-hoo-hoo!
And the four kings and queens ruled for years and years, and brought to Narnia an era of peace and joy and prosperity that the land had not known before, even in its sweetest olden days. Then one day, the white stag, who granted to anyone who caught him three wishes, reappeared, and the kings and queens went a-hunting after him.
Over here, fair brother and good sisters.
As did I.
And I.
Never have I pursued a more noble quarry. Where did he go?
Into that thicket, I believe.
A very dense thicket, filled with briars and underbrush.
But as good kings and queens of Narnia, we always achieve what we set out to do.
Our brother is right. Before we pursue the white stag further, I suggest we leave our robes and crowns here so they will not get damaged in yon thicket.
This lamp on the post worketh strangely upon me, as though I have seen it before, in a dream.
I agree. Seemeth that there lies a strange adventure on this side of the lamppost.
Then, in the name of Aslan, let us take this adventure.
Wait for us, good brother and good sister.
Brother, this lamppost worketh strangely upon me, just as it did for Lucy and Edmund.
I too feel its peculiar effect.
Hey, where are we?
You're in the thicket, of course.
No, we're not. We're in a wardrobe?
Wardrobe?
Oh, yes. I had almost forgotten about it.
Yes.
Gosh, me too.
Nothing has changed, and the clock has hardly even moved.
Hurry up, you two. Maybe we'll be in time for dinner.
I suppose it's time to leave, Peter.
I guess so.
Peter, do you think we'll ever return to Narnia again?
If we're lucky, Susan. If we're very lucky.
Goodbye.
because they can't feel it too doesn't mean that you have to forget. Let your memories grow stronger and stronger till they're before your eyes. You'll come back when they call you. No need to say goodbye.
The paths that lead to Narnia. For once a king in Narnia is always a king. And for once a queen in Narnia is always a queen. For it is important that they return. For good people need good rulers. And good rulers need good people. Perhaps that is the deepest magic of all.
Thank you.